If you've worked hard your whole life and have saved up a big chunk of cash, will you give that nest egg to your children or spend it all when you retire? For a growing number of Aussie parents, the answer is spend, spend, spend.
More Aussie boomers are embracing a trend known as ski. And no, it doesn't mean hitting the slopes. SKI instead referring to spending kids' inheritance.
The SKI movement is all about enjoying your retirement to the full and not scrabbling away every penny to pass it on to your kids.
A movement that's gaining traction with several online groups dedicated to the cause, urging parents to shell out cash on adventures before it's too late.
It's about inspiring people to have holidays if that's what they want to do.
If you dream about going somewhere, you can do it.
And while some of their kids are totally on board,
it's their money, so I think they should be able to do whatever they'd like with it.
Others feel parents should pass on some of the unique financial advantages their generation has enjoyed.
I'm probably never going to be able to afford a house without any help.
Younger generations look at the baby boomers and they say, you had free education, you've had a massive, massive win with the property market. We don't have those advantages, so we need your help.
In spite of the skiers, we're still on track for the greatest intergenerational wealth transfer in history, with baby boomers in Australia set to pass on $3.5 trillion in assets to their heirs over the next two decades.
It's all about finding that right balance so that the kids understand what they're trying to achieve in terms of living a full life on the one hand and helping out future generations on the other hand.
But for Mandy Watson, leaving money to her children isn't a priority. After surviving a cancer diagnosis in 2016, she decided to instead spend that money on travelling the world with her husband, Trevor.
We love to travel. We love to go to new places. You just don't know what's around the corner health-wise, and we dodged a few bullets in our way.
And they don't plan on stopping anytime soon.
I mean, that's rubbing it in for all of us.
Wow.
Welcome to the project. We are live from the lands of the Kulin Nation, and Mandy Watson is not there.
Yes.
She runs the website Spending Kids Inheritance. She's doing that right now on a grand 10-week holiday through Europe.
Oh,
Mandy, firstly, where in the world are you?
Yes.
I am in St Mark's Square in Venice, and my hotel room is looking straight out at the piazza. It's incredible. We're just here for 2 nights.
Hang on. Show us.
Yeah, prove it.
Don't just show us wallpaper.
Okay.
We want to see.
Prove it.
Here we go. Oh, hello, Trevor.
Oh.
Oh, my goodness.
AI is incredible these days. That's unbelievable.
Oh, what a hideous sight that you have to endure, Mandy. I'm so sorry.
Oh, and the bell. I had to put earplugs in because the bells kept me awake.
Mandy, are you having as much fun as it seems?
We're having more. It's just, we were in America doing a cross-country drive about a month ago saying, I can't believe we're going to be in Venice on this holiday. We were in Idaho and it's like, here we are. The world is just, it's just a plane ride away. It really is.
By the way, a hotel on that square, are you trying to spend as much of your inheritance as possible, as quickly as possible?
But this is what happens when Trevor lets me alone with bookings.com and I just find some random places. Sorry, oops.
What else have you both been spending your money on?
Well, it's mainly on travel these days. We're not really into buying stuff anymore. We're really into experiences, and the more the better, and the more that we get into a physical activity. Like we went dog sledding up in Northern Norway, like Svalbard, which is about 700 miles from the North Pole. We were there probably 3 weeks ago and now we're sweating our buns off in humid Italy. It's so fun, so fun.
Dog sledding? What's dog sledding?
Well, we had huskies and there was no snow. Oh, there was snow, but it's the summer, but they've got to keep them fit, so they're on wheels.
Oh,
and Trevor, my husband, he was driving them and I was in front and it was just fantastic. And they're so well loved and they're just jumping out of their skins with joy, these things. It was so fun.
I think the point is, Sam, you don't have enough money to find out what
I'm a millennial. I'll never get to experience. That's why I'm trying to find out information about it. I'm going to ask some tough questions, unfortunately, Mandy. So your kids' generations have had a tougher time with things like property, for example. Do you feel guilty at all for the dog sledding and the beautiful views?
Trev?
No.
Yeah, no. But that's us. That's our situation. Our kids are behind us. We've done the long haul. run a business and built houses and lived in garages while we build houses, and they've done it with us, and they've sort of seen that this now, we just retired last year, so we've finally got time and money at the same time. We've never had them at the same time. So this time we can get out there and just do it, and with their blessing. There'll be a bit left over for them, and as my son said, as long as the funeral's prepaid, we're good to go.
Mandy, what are you and Trevor next up to?
Oh, today, actually, after this interview, where our bags are packed and we're heading, I hate to say it, I'm so sorry, onto another cruise. We've got a 9-day cruise.
Oh, my Croatian goodness.
Beautiful. Hey, Trevor, can you pop in? How do you rate skiing?
Oh, come on, Trev. In you come, babe.
Trevor, what are your thoughts? What are your thoughts?
I'm sorry.
We're doing what we're doing.
Oh, it's great. We miss home, but while we can travel, you've got to get out and do it. It's out there waiting for us.
And you know, the people that we come across, the older people than us, they're traveling too, and they say, "Do it while you can."
I love it. I love the motto, Mandy, Trevor. Enjoy Croatia.
Okay. Thank you. Wow.
Must be nice.
Did we have to open watching that?
Ridiculous. Hey, guys, this morning...
I love it for them.
Look, for them, it's great, but yeah, doesn't it remind you how crushingly at a desk you are?
Yeah, but that's how life works, Waleed.
Oh, harsh reality of life.
Not everyone gets what everyone else gets.
No, I understand. Okay.
Some of us get to hang out with you.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. What a treasure.